Hey, ladies and gentlemen, it's your good buddy Dave from Kart Speed again. And today, guys, I'm coming at you with another video. The subject we're going to talk about today isn't as debated as cross, but there are some arguments, you know, back and forth a little bit on what this adjustment actually does. And today we're going to talk about front end lead. Now, I know that over the last few weeks and in the last few videos that we've done, you know, we've covered a lot of information. And it's a lot to take in. And I, you know, naturally am an encourager. All right, so I just want to give you a word of encouragement.
You is kind. You is smart. You is important. You is smart. You is kind. You is important. That's so good.
See, I feel better. Don't you feel better? So now we can tackle today's video. So today's video is not going to be as long as last week's video.
Nah, man.
Because again, I'm becoming an old man. I can't keep doing that every single week. You know, I don't have the stamina like the young kids do.
Come on, David.
But this video is designed, again, to give you just the meat and potatoes of what's happening, not really the full dynamics of what's going on, okay? I just want you to have the nuts and bolts so you can apply it at the racetrack. So usually, when you talk about front-end lead, well, before we get into that, what is front-end lead? Well, front-end lead is when you move the caster block on the chassis caster plate, either forward or backwards, on the left front and the right front, okay? So when you do that, a lot of people immediately think it just has to do with wheelbase and you should always run the left front in the rear position and the right front in the forward position because that's what will make the go-kart turn the best. Well, that's not entirely true, okay? What front-end lead does is it actually changes the speed in which weight is transferred, and on the right front, it'll actually change the amount of weight that's being transferred, okay?
Hold up, David, you gotta stop. You're crossing me up here.
So let's kind of talk about that for a second. So here on my board, I have two chassis drawn. Again, not the scale. I say this every video. Y'all don't pick on me too bad about the way I draw the go-karts. And it's not to scale, it is kind of exaggerated, so it makes it easier to explain. Okay, so we're gonna start off with the right front. So when you put the right front in the rear position, okay, what you're actually doing is increasing the speed in which it transfers weight to the right front. And the easy way to think about this is you're actually shortening the distance that the weight has to travel to get to the right front, okay? That's the way I think about it in my mind, and it makes it easier to remember, okay? But more importantly, what you're really doing is you're moving the right front closer to the center gravity of the go-kart. And when you do that, what happens is you end up transferring more weight onto the right front at a quicker speed, okay? Which what will happen then, when you move the right front to the rear position, the go-kart is going to want to tuck the right front in and get on the right front a whole lot harder and turn, okay? So it will definitely speed up the front end of the go-kart, and the go-kart is definitely going to want to turn faster. Because again, you're speeding up the transfer, the weight transfer from the left rear to the right front, okay? And you're bringing the right front closer to the go-kart's center of gravity. Well then, what happens when you move it forward? Well, in this one, when we move it forward, again, you're moving the right front away from the go-kart's center of gravity, and it takes longer for the weight to transfer to the right front. So therefore, you're essentially taking bite out of the right front, and therefore it will slow the front end down, and the go-kart's not going to want to transfer as much weight onto the right front, therefore it's not going to turn as much.
Yes! That's awesome!
So let's talk about the left front, okay? So the left front essentially works the same way, okay? If you move it to the forward position, one, the left front's all gonna track better around the turn, but it slows down the weight transfer to the right rear. And when it slows down that weight transfer, that means the weight stays on your left front a little bit longer, letting the front turn more, but then the right rear isn't getting loaded as fast, and because it's not getting loaded as fast, its tendency is to slide, causing the go-kart to turn more, okay? Well, what happens if you move it to the rear position? You are increasing the speed of the weight transfer, and the right rear, when it goes into the turn and the lateral forces hit it, the right rear gets loaded much faster, causing the go-kart not to want to turn as fast, okay?
You're crazy, man. You're crazy. I like you, but you're crazy.
And I know what you're thinking. Well, David, if the go-kart turns the best with the left front forward and the right front back, why don't I just run it that way all the time? Because I like a go-kart that cuts and turns, you know? Well, the negative to that is the go-kart doesn't roll as well with the left front forward and the right front back. You actually scrub speed down the straightaway doing that. Normally, I like to run either the left front back and the right front forward, or both the left front and the right front in the forward position or the rear position. The only time that I run the left front forward and the right front back is if I'm indoor racing or it's an extremely, extremely, extremely small racetrack. That way, I'm not really worried about straightaway speed. I'm just trying to cut through the turn the best I can. And that's why most guys like that run concrete, indoor concrete, or indoor dirt will typically run the left front forward and the right front back because they're not so much concerned about roll speed down the straightaway. They're more concerned about the go-kart cutting and getting through the turn. On the flip side of that, if you go down to Triple T, or Possum Kingdom, a track that has long straightaways, or like Triple T is a momentum-based racetrack, if you run the left front forward and the right front back, you are going to kill your speed because the go-kart's not going to want to roll as well. I knew you would agree, Cody. Guys, I hope that over these past few videos and this video, that you'll be able to take the right tire combination and match it with the right chassis setup. So the next time you're in a race, you'll
R-U-N-N-O-F-T
from the competition. Till next time, remember, don't leave no speed in the trailer.